few months ago, I gave my studio wall a transformation into a giant colouring book. It took 3 whole days from the design to cutting everything out with my Cricut Maker to mapping it out on my wall, then slowly piecing together the crazy jigsaw puzzle I had created, mostly without any major dramas. Today, we're doing it all again. Okay, wait, let me clarify. We're not redoing it all. That would be crazy. But I never quite finished this wall. I was working with a very limited amount of vinyl, which I talked about in that video. So it doesn't quite reach the top, and there are a few areas I'd like to add some more details. I didn't do anything on my side wall at all, and so this just all feels a little unfinished to be. My biggest hold up in doing all of this again, or really my excuse for procrastinating, has been the amount of effort it took to break up these large sections into smaller pieces so they would fit within the 12 by 12 inch cutting area that the Cricut Maker could handle. My whole project took 3 days, and at least one of those days could have been saved if my Cricut Maker could just cut a larger area for a project like this. Today, however, this will not be a problem because Cricut Australia have sent me the new Cricut Explore 3. The Cricut Explore 3 offers a massive upgrade from the previous Cricut Maker with twice the cutting speed. It can cut more than 100 different materials up to 3.6 meters long or about 12 feet, which is a huge upgrade from the previous cutting size. Race, go. In order to cut the extra length, this doesn't use a mat and uses what they call smart materials. So Cricut have sent me some of these too. I've also got some extra attachments here to try. I've got a scoring wheel, an engraving tip, a perforation blade, and a knife blade. So let me know if any of these spark any particular ideas that you'd like to see in a future video, and make sure you subscribe. But let's get started with today's project with a new photo of the studio and a digital mock-up. I'm using the same process as last time with Adobe Illustrator to plan out my design on top of an actual photo of my room. Then I can use this file in Illustrator to scale up these drawings to the right size and prepare them for cutting. This time I can fit my designs in a much larger cutting area, 3.6 meters by 30 centimeters. I'll still do a little bit of rearranging to avoid wasting vinyl, but I've learned from my mistakes and I've created a color system, so it will be much easier to find the right pieces later, I hope. But before we cut, let's do a draft with the paper like we did last time. This just helps me to visualize the layout and make sure my scale is correct. I think it's vinyl time. I've saved my artwork as a PNG, so let's upload it into Cricut's design space. Being only black and white, we can choose the simple image type and then erase any white sections that should be transparent. Then I'm choosing cut image and resizing my image to the correct size with the measurements along the screen. I think we're good to go. This part always makes me nervous. Have I done everything? So we've got one giant project. It is 12 feet long, 360 centimeters of artwork to do in one hit. Let's do it. I haven't actually read any instructions for this, but this feels logical. Okay, let's try. Oh, yep, it's doing something. Measuring material length. It doesn't believe me that I have enough. It's unraveling the whole roll. You happy now? I told you that it was enough vinyl. All right, let's go. Yeah, this is faster for sure. Oh, look at it go, so fast. So I found a piece of the vinyl that I used from last time, and the smart vinyl is almost identical in how it looks. But interestingly, the back is actually quite a lot thicker. And I think that's because the smart vinyl also acts as its own mat. So you actually don't need a Cricut mat to use this in the machine, which is really cool. And I think that's how you end up being able to print on the really long sheets rather than being limited to the size of the mat. Why did it just stop? This isn't supposed to happen. I don't know. What's gonna happen? If I just press go, will it keep going or will it start again? I'm scared now. Do I just try it?
So this is where things got a little frustrating. Every time I tried cutting my design, it just stopped midway with no explanation.
It stopped again. I don't know what it's doing.
Oh no, 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 don't stop. Why do you keep stopping? No.
No, what happened? We're about to pass our previous record.
I tried so many different things and eventually called Cricut's Help Center, who were incredibly helpful and arranged for a whole new machine for us. But we didn't know until later that it wasn't the machine that was causing the problems. It was my desk. For some reason, my desk was creating so much static along the long piece of vinyl that the Cricut kept stopping. Of course, I didn't work this out until after we'd wasted a lot of vinyl, waited 3 weeks for a replacement machine, and already moved on to a few other videos over the past few weeks. I even forgot to take down my makeshift wall while we filmed. But all this was worth it if it helped someone else to avoid the same issue that ended up being extremely easy to fix by moving the Cricut Explore 3 from my desk to the floor, where it cut the full 3.6 meters of vinyl perfectly. Look at it go! I feel bad now for sending the first machine back. Sorry, Cricut. So here we are, it's a new week, a new machine, and even a new haircut. And it's finally time to start weeding this vinyl. This is actually my favorite part of this whole process. Is that weird? Watching the vinyl separate along the perfectly cut edges to reveal a beautiful design underneath is just satisfying. And the weeding tools that Cricut have sent me make it so much easier than trying to do this with tweezers or by hand. So I'm not really sure what's so special about my desk, but now that we know that it's a static issue, it does feel kind of obvious. The vinyl gets a lot heavier as soon as it touches the desk. Wonder how much we can charge this. With that problem solved, it's time to move on to our puzzle piece, and I'm planning for it to be a lot easier this time than it was last time, thanks to our color code system. Here's the part where my color code system is going to save hours compared to last time. I've still jumbled up my pieces somewhat to save space on my vinyl, but I've color coded the groups on my paper chart here to match the designs on my wall. So I won't be trying to guess which lines connect to which, and the overall puzzle should be far less confusing. I still added a lot of little extra pieces that aren't in my design, so I didn't waste any vinyl. I'll just add these at the end wherever they fit on the wall. I don't need to plan them out beforehand. To transfer the vinyl from the backing to my wall, I'm using transfer tape. This is like a sheet of semi-sticky click contact that can keep the design flat and keep all the details together, but allow me to remove the backing. Without this, these vinyl stickers would be a nightmare to place on the wall without twisting or getting out of shape. You can reuse the same transfer tape a few times. I even layer multiple pieces on top of each other if I've got an area that's too big for just one piece. It saves a lot of tape in the long run and means that I can do this entire wall without even using a whole roll. I still have lots of sorting and sticking to do, but this is so much easier than it was last time. Mainly because I've been able to cut these large pieces as one section with the larger cutting capacity of the Cricut Explore 3, instead of having to piece together all the little sections from a 12 by 12 inch mat like last time. I've still broken up a few sections to make better use of the vinyl, but they have been easier to reassemble. Now I know why the paper jumped off the wall when I did this in my other video. It was the static. I wasn't going crazy. Look at this. So far, I've had no major mess-ups or breaks, and things are going well. supposed to be doing that. Oh no. Oh no. I made it worse. I put the wrong side down. Why did I do? Oh, it's like the funniest thing I've ever done. Might just reprint this one this time, I think. We knew this was gonna happen at least once. At least this time I have extra vinyl. Whoops, I missed the frame completely. Time to compromise. Back to the weeding. I think that's everything now from the plan, so I'm just making the rest up as I go with all these extra little pieces that I've cut out. I found some of the vinyl from our failed cuts a few weeks ago and have salvaged the sections that cut successfully before the machine stopped. There are actually a few really good pieces here, so we might add them to our wall too. We're almost done. Did I maybe go overboard? Everything finally feels complete. I am so happy with how this turned out. I even have a spare vinyl, but I feel like there's nothing more I can add. I am just done. I'm actually really ready to just call it a night, because this was a really big project and it was a lot of fun, and I want to thank Cricut Australia again for sending me this, but I think I'm done for the night, unless Shane, you can think of anything else we need to say.
Well, there's this in the mail.
Who's this from? From Johanna Basford. Ooh, what has Johanna sent me? Actually, let's leave this for next week.